Hi everyone, today we will be discussing why SAP Bapi is still relevant even with the advent of Fiori UiFi and Odata Services and Core Data Services, which is CDS. So let's take a deep dive into it. So first of all, let us understand what is a Bapi. Bapi is a business application programming interface. Before SAP R3 4.0 version, there were remote function calls which were available. And post that, SAP came up with this concept of BAPIs. Now, BAPIs are still used in the ABAP RESTful programming, and it is still relevant as far as object-oriented classes, CDS, ODATA services, and Fiori apps and other things are concerned. Now, primarily, this is due to the extensive usage of the BAPIs in the existing system. So for understanding that, let us understand the roadmap of SAP UI for last 30 or 25 years. So let's start with the beginning. Earlier, there were only dialog transactions which were available in SAP. When I say dialog transactions, which means module pools, dialog modules, or reports and other things which were purely SAP GUI based. And to interact with other systems, SAP had provided remote function calls, which is the RSC function module. So the moment you enable any function module as RSC enabled, that was available to the external world. That was the only way which was available, or else there were file interfaces and other things which were available. Then came ITS, which is Internet Transaction Server. And this enabled SAP, the user to send data to SAP on a web-based UI. It was crude. However, it was available. I had used it somewhere in year 2002 or something like that. Then came Portal, and it used Java Web Bin Pro. And after that came business server pages, which were developed on the ABAP stack, and they were available as a web UI to the user. Then came ABAP Web Bin Pro, and at the same time, in similar time frame, SAP had introduced web services, and this transaction SICF was available somewhere around 2004 or 2005. That's what I remember using it. And after that came web UI using general model. Now, those who have only worked on ECC projects, that typically that is what happens, might not have got exposed to web UI using general model. But those people who have worked on CRM projects, this was heavily used. So I had used this web UI using general model somewhere around 2006 or 2007 in CRM projects using OOP programming, etc. And after that, SAP came up with the new UI, which is Floorplan Manager. And it was available somewhere around 2011. That's where I used a floor plan manager. And after that, they came up with Fiori, UiFi, and ODATA services. Now, if you see this UI stack for SAP, which has evolved over the last 30 years or so, there is one thing which is common across all these UIs is BAPIs. So what SAP did was they decided that, okay, we will allow the external system or the any other user to use a web-based UI to interact with the SAP system. And that was the need of the hour. They kept on improving the web UI on need of the user, on basis of the user needs. And as technology evolved, they improved their UI. But there was one thing which remained constant, which is the BAPIs or APIs. And this is nothing but the business programming logic, business logic, which is behind, posting the date master data or transactional data back to SAP system, and at times fetching the data from the SAP system to the web UI. And this was done using these SAP standard BAPIs. Now, these BAPIs also cater to the user exits and the enhancements and other things which are developed in the SAP UI. And that is how, you know, it took care of the custom logic which is developed on the SAP UI. And at the same time, the users could use these custom logic and validation which is there in the SAP system using this APIs. And this is the reason why SAP did not touch the BAPIs or made any major changes as far as the BAPI or this backbone to push the data back into SAP system is concerned. And at the same time, over a period of like let's say 30 years or so, if any customer is using a SAP system, they also developed their own technical debt. They had their own reports, workflows, and few other custom reports and other things which use these APIs, and they developed their user exits and custom logic in those user exits, etc. Now, suddenly, if SAP changes this business APIs, which is used to expose data to and from the SAP system, you will be forcing your customer to change their technical debt, and which will in turn cause a lot of cost. So to keep this technical debt intact and the business logic and the customers, more than that, the customer's business running, SAP has kept this backbone constant. So that is how BAPIs are still relevant even after, let's say, 20 or 30 years. The UI will keep on changing, but the business programming logic behind the scenes to post data back into the system will remain the same. So that's it from my side. Thank you. Bye.